This is the center half of the salwar. At this point, we're just going to mark it off with a notch. The seams, these are the straight seams that we've done in the middle, and then this is the center seam. Now the two of these we're going to attach together. So that's the two sides of the salwar. I'm filming from a different angle so you can get a slightly better view of what it is that we are sketching. So make sure you've got both your right sides together. Again, hold these two pieces and these should be notched on the center. This is the center of the salwar. So these are two symmetrical pieces, one on either side. That's your second part of the galli, and then this is the crutch area of the salwar. So on the one side, we're going to attach both the crotch seams together. Just a straight seam. Now, if you remember, we pre-marked these earlier. And these are marked on a 4-inch and a 1-inch distance. So go to the end, place your belt part underneath. This is the belt. The belt has also been notched into sections. That's half of the belt on one side. This is the center half of the belt. Then that's the other side that will be the back of the salwar. And this is the other side that will be to the front of the salwar. You can make the belt wider according to your own hip measurement. This is for like a size up to 8, 10, 12 and so on. So from the first 1-inch seam, just tuck down and then form a pleat from that point of the 1-inch. You are halving up to the point. As soon as your pleat is under, pick up the point from the 1-inch going all the way up to where we've marked it off at the 4-inch. So you will have to lift the foot, push the fabric underneath the first seam and meet up where you've marked your second point, which is here. So these are on 1-inch, and then sew a little bit. Again, pick up from where the distance of the 1-inch is in between. Tuck in up to the point of where your second part of your marking is. And this is for anyone. This will guarantee you absolute even pleating all the way around. So you are going forward, lifting the foot up, pleating that up to so that both your notches are matching and seaming down. As soon as you've trapped your pleat, it's trapped now. If you, well, just a little bit, maybe a little bit further, that's trapped in now. Again, you are, it's a slow and frustrating process, but if you can perfect the pleating of this salwar, then you've actually mastered the whole of the technique. So again, lift up the fabric, fold it into up to the mark of the second notch. Make sure that the pleats are sitting and the angles are meeting up and going on to the next one. And this you follow all the way through up till all your fabric is actually consumed in the same manner. So like I said, it's a painstaking procedure, but then if you were to get this made by someone, obviously they will charge you for the time. And if you are to do it yourself, then you would value the fact that you had spent time on the making of this salwar and you will get the result. So each pleat we are forming and leaving a distance of 1 inch in between, and a 4-inch in between we are folding so that each of our pieces are matching up exactly to the previous piece. Now we're approaching our center mark. There is a break in the fabric here.